Good morning. Good morning. Welcome back to Coffee and the Word. I had to reach for my coffee here. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I hope and pray that you're doing well this morning. I'm coming back from a workout and it was a good one, a really good one. Well, they're all good. It's just this one had a lot of running in it and I left it all out there. It was good stuff. Good stuff. All right, well, let's get started. This morning, we have a passage from Psalm 139. Then we're going back to Genesis. And then we have a reading in Galatians. So, Psalm 139, verses 13 through 18. And as always, may God bless the reading of His Word. For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed substance. In your book were written every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! If I would count them, they are more than the sand. I awake, and I am still with you. And that's good stuff. Good stuff. All right. Genesis chapter 33, verses 1 through 17. This is where Jacob meets Esau. And Jacob lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, Esau was coming, and 400 men with him. So he divided the children among Leah and Rachel and the two female servants. And he put the servants with their children in front, then Leah with her children, and Rachel and Joseph last of all. He himself went on before them, bowing himself to the ground seven times until he came near to his brother. But Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him, and they wept. And when Esau lifted up his eyes and saw the women and children, he said, "Who are these with you?" And Jacob said, "The children whom God has graciously given your servant." Then the servants drew near, they and their children, and bowed down. Leah, likewise, and her children drew near and bowed down. At last, Joseph and Rachel drew near, and they bowed down. Esau said, "What do you mean by all this company that I met?" Jacob answered, "To find favor in the sight of my Lord." But Esau said, "I have enough, my brother. Keep what you have for yourself." Jacob said, "No, please, if I have found favor in your sight, then accept my present from my hand. For I have seen your face, which is like seeing the face of God, and you have accepted me. Please accept my blessing that is brought to you because God has dealt graciously with me, and because I have enough." Thus he urged him, and he took it. Then Esau said, "Let us journey on our way, and I will go ahead of you." But Jacob said to him, "My Lord knows that the children are frail, and that the nursing flocks and herds are a care to me. If they are driven hard for one day, all the flocks will die. Let my Lord pass on ahead of his servants, and I will lead on slowly, at the pace of the livestock that are ahead of me, and at the pace of the children, until I come to my Lord in Seir." So Esau said, "Let me leave you with some of the people who are with me." But he said, "What need is there? Let me find favor in the sight of my Lord." So Esau returned that day on his way to Seir. But Jacob journeyed to Succoth and built himself a house and made booths for his livestock. Therefore, the name of the place is called Succoth. Good stuff. Good stuff. Let me get a little bit of coffee here. All right, next we're going to Galatians chapter 4, verses 21 through chapter 5, verse 1. This is an example of Hagar and Sarah. "Tell me, you who desire to be under the law, do you not listen to the law? For it is written that Abraham had two sons, one by a slave woman and one by a free woman. But the son of the slave was born according to the flesh, while the son of the free woman was born through promise. Now this may be interpreted allegorically. These women are two covenants. One is from Mount Sinai, bearing children for slavery. She is Hagar. Now Hagar is Mount Sinai in Arabia. she corresponds to the present Jerusalem, for she is in slavery with her children. But the Jerusalem above is free, and she is our mother, for it is written, Rejoice, O barren one who does not bear. Break forth and cry aloud, you who are not in labor. For the children of the desolate one will be more than those of the one who has a husband. Now you, brothers, like Isaac, are children of promise. But just as at that time he who was born according to the flesh persecuted him who was born according to the Spirit, so also it is now. But what does the Scripture say? Cast out the slave woman and her son, for the son of the slave woman shall not inherit with the son of the free woman. So, brothers, we are not children of the slave, but of the free woman. For freedom, Christ has set us free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. And this is the word of the Lord. All right. We'll go to the Pray Now app and for the prayer of the day. All right. Let us pray. O gracious God, your servant and apostle James was the first among the 12 to suffer martyrdom for the name of Jesus Christ. Pour out upon the leaders of your church that spirit of self-denying service, that they may forsake all false and passing allurements and follow Christ alone, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. There's a little paragraph here I'd like to share with you. It's entitled, St. James the Elder Apostle. St. James and his brother John, sons of Zebedee and Salome, were fishermen in the Sea of Galilee, who were called with Peter and his brother Andrew to follow Jesus. In the Gospel list of Jesus' disciples, James is listed following Peter and preceding John. Together, these three appear as leaders of the 12. Because James precedes John, it is reasoned that James is the elder of the brothers. The book of Acts records that James was beheaded by Herod Agrippa I, probably between AD 42 and 44. Thus, James is the first of the 12 to die a martyr. Interesting. All right. Well, I hope and pray that you all have a fantastic day. Yeah, that's it. That's all I've got. So with that, y'all have an awesome day. Be safe, be happy, and be blessed. We'll see you tomorrow morning on Coffee and the Word. God bless.